the coffee break for 20 minutes and reconvene here at
On the other hand, olefins formed on the zeolite moves into to hydrogenation catalyst to form paramines. This propane and butane is the target product of that of our research. The catalyst used in this study, as shown here, xenolite catalyst used by protonated type and USY, Z5, and beta type xenolite. Hybrid catalyst was declared by mixing physically hydrogenation catalyst and xenolite. Hydrogenation catalyst used was methanol synthesis catalyst, such as copper zinc oxide, commercial one, and silica supported on palladium catalyst, prepared by incipient wetland impregnation method. Another hydrogenation catalyst, hydrotreating catalyst, such as cobalt or molybdenum catalyst were also used. Another one, noble metal modified zeolite has been also used. Palladium or platinum incorporated by ion exchange or with impregnation. The catalyst size was this size, and the activation procedure is shown here. This picture shows the reaction apparatus and feeding system of DME. DME is stored the tank and liquefied. And the DME is fed by saturation with hydrogen as a carrier. The reactor is a conventional prototype stainless tube reactor and under pressure. Now let's move on to the experimental results. The first screening of the catalyst was conducted using methanol synthesis catalyst as a hydrogenation catalyst with different zeolites. This slide shows the catalyst performances. From now on, these types of bioflux will be appeared in the following slides. The upper figure showed the DME conversion to hydrocarbon, carbon monoxide, and carbon dioxide on the basis of carbon, and the sum of them indicate the total DME conversion. The lower figure indicates the distribution of hydrocarbons also on the basis of carbon. The green bars and green bars indicate the C3, that is propane. Blue bars indicate butanes are target products. When the zeolite, USY or ZSM5 were employed as a catalyst, DME conversion was not so high. And the mixture of olefins and paraffins was obtained. Large amount of heavier hydrocarbons, C5 plus, were also formed. So the activity of the zeolite decreased very quickly due to the formation of heavy hydrocarbons. When the hybrid catalyst combined methanol synthesis catalyst and zeolite, such as copper zinc and calcium modified palladium catalyst. The the DM conversion reached around 100%. And the olefins in product were hydrogenated into aramids, so no olefins was observed in this system. USY and beta zeolite with a large pore size zeolite gave higher selectivity to DM fraction than ZSM5 with smaller pore size. The hydrate catalyst Kappa zinc and USY showed the highest selectivity to LPG fraction, about more than 75%. Unfortunately, however, a considerable amount of DME decomposed into C1, CO2. These unfavorable products could be formed through the DME hydration to methanol and its decomposition into CO and hydrogen. Some CO was also converted into CO2 by the ship reaction. The direct decomposition of DME to CO, methane, and hydrogen would be also possible. The next stream was performed using hydrotreating catalysts for heavy oils such as molybdenum, nickel, cobalt, molybdenum, cobalt, molybdenum, nickel system, which are supported on alumina. In these cases, DME decomposition was suppressed, and almost all the products were hydrocarbons. However, the LPG contents were low, around 30-40%. So it's not suitable for the catalyst. The third screening was conducted with noble metal ion exchange zeolites. After ZSM5 was modified by ion exchange, palladium or platinum into zeolite, its performance was changed remarkably. With these catalysts, DME conversion reached about 100%, and almost no CO and very little C1 CO2 formation. There was no olefin found in the product because the intermediate olefins produced from DME were hydrogenated in situ, catalyzed by palladium and platinum metal. So the activity of zeolite was promoted. The major hydrocarbon products were C2, C3, and C4 hydrocarbons. The yield of methane was very low, especially when using palladium ZSM5 catalyst. Totally, activity and selectivity for LPG formation was more than 50%. Although platinum ZSM5 showed a slightly higher selectivity than palladium one, it gave more C1, CO2 than when the zeolite used USY or beta showed a very poor selectivity to LPG, giving only methane and so the reason has not yet been the reason has not been clear yet. Since palladium or platinum modified ZSM5 catalyst showed fairly high performances, effect of metal content and preparation method has been examined. For both catalysts, palladium ZSM5 and platinum ZSM5, the content of LPG fraction in hydrocarbon changed little. With different metal content in zeolite. Here, 0.1% to 0.5%. But the ratio of propane to butane increased with the increasing in metal loading. The modified DSM-5 with high metal content tends to produce a low yield of heavier hydrocarbons. Thus, DSM-5 with high metal content would have high stability for the reaction. Compared with platinum DSM-5, palladium DSM-5 had a better selectivity for hydrocarbon and LPG because the yield of unfavorable product CO and CO2 is small. The ion exchange DSM-5 with a small amount of palladium showed a high selectivity to LPG. But C2 selectivity was also high. So in the last screen, palladium supported on silica was used again, and in this case, the palladium silica with USY20 with a silica ratio, 1 to 2 is the best catalyst. Zeolite produces a mixture of propanes and paraffins with low DME conversion. Again, hybrid catalysts composed of methanol catalysis catalysts and zeolite give high DME conversions and high LPG contents in hydrocarbon products. However, considerable amounts of CO and CO form. Although hybrid catalysts composed of hydrogen catalysts and zeolite suppress carbon oxide formation, selectivity to LPG are very low. Palladium and platinum modified DSM-5 promotes LPG production with yield about 50%. And the most active and selective catalyst for LPG is palladium silica USY hybrid catalyst, which gives almost 100% conversion and more than 65 LPG selectivity has been obtained. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Dr. Rekasani. So, one or two quick questions. I had a question about the hydrothermal stability of this catalyst. Were you able to measure or to observe the hydrothermal stability?
Hydrothermal stability. In this system, the catalyst deactivation has been observed for mainly due to the formation of fog and zeolite catalyst deactivated. But about 10 or 20 hours is very stable. But several hundred hours when the deactivation is serious.
Any other questions? If not, then we thank Dr. Kasani once more. So it's now my pleasure to introduce